Hello students, today our topic is excretion, which is the last topic of the chapter life processes. Student, you should know that during the biochemical reactions of the cells, there are two things are produced. One is toxic waste are produced during the biochemical reactions, and water content can be increased or decreased. To overcome these, there are two general processes which we have to discuss, that is excretion, the biological process involved in the removal of harmful toxic waste. All the harmful toxic waste, that is also called as metabolic waste, excreted out from the body is called as excretion, right? Next is osmoregulation process. It is the biological process of maintaining the right amount of water and the proper ionic balance in the body is called as osmoregulation. That means osmoregulation is very important for us to regulate the right amount of water, and proper ionic balance is maintained by this process. Both of these point to be noted, students, both of these process go on side by side, and these functions are done by the special excretory system, or we can say it as urinary system. Let us discuss some excretory organs in different animals. There are different excretory organs present in different type of animals, as in the case of unicellular amoeba, contractile vacuole is there, which is acting as the excretory organ, right? Contractile vacuole. In Hydra, oral opening is enough to excrete out the toxic waste, and it is acting as the excretory organ. In earthworm, nephridia are the excretory organs, right students? And in arthropoda, or in the insects, you have remembered that malpighian tubules are the excretory organs. In human beings now, as you know, the kidneys are the main excretory organs in the human beings. This may be asked in one mark question or in MCQs in the board exams, and this is also given in the NCERT. Okay, point note all the things. The components of the human excretory system. There are the four important components. As first is, a pair of kidneys are present in our abdominal cavity. And these kidneys are bean shaped, about 10 to 12 centimeter in length and 4 to 5 centimeter in width, we can say. Next component is a pair of ureters. These ureters are duct like tubes which collect the waste from the kidney to the urinary bladder. Third component is a urinary bladder which stores the nitrogenous waste in the form of urine. Store as urine. And a urethra. Urethra function is all the urine or the excretory waste which is coming out from the kidney is excreted out through the urethra. Now, I will explain you all these components with the help of diagram. Let us take a look of the diagram of human excretory system. As you can see, students, these are the two kidneys, and there are pair of ureters which connect these kidneys with the urinary bladder, and this is the urethra. This is the four components which we have discussed earlier. Now take a look of the two type of blood vessels which are playing a very important role in the excretory system. Start from this red one. This is the largest artery of the body, which is called as aorta. This artery, that is labeled as aorta, it has some branches which are entered into the kidney, respective kidneys. That is, this is the left kidney which I have labeled, and this one is the right kidney. In both the kidneys, there are the small arteries which are coming out from the aorta. These are called as renal artery. You have to label it as renal artery because it is related to the kidney. And now, the other blood vessel, which I have shown with the bluish color, this is the largest vein of the body, which is labeled as vena cava. एंड थ्रू दी वेना कावा देयर आर स्मॉल ब्रांचेस ऑफ आर्टरीज विच आर कनेक्टेड द किडनी विच कनेक्ट द किडनी दैट आर लेबल्ड एज रीनल वेन राइट. Now let us understand how and what type of blood is coming through these blood vessels. In the aorta, there is the oxygenated blood is coming to the kidneys which contain nitrogenous waste or the impurities which has to be excreted out through the kidneys. Therefore, this type of blood is called, which is coming through the aorta into the kidney, is called as impure blood. Right? Now this blood is enter into the respective kidneys through the arteries which is called as renal artery, which contain impure blood or that blood which is going to be filtered. Now kidney's role is to filter this blood, to separate the blood and separate the nitrogenous waste from the blood. Nitrogenous waste which is going to be separated by the excretory units of the kidney has to be transported or collected through the ureter and then stored into the urinary blood. But the good type of blood or the pure blood which is not going to be wasted in the ureter, that is collected again by the help of renal vein, and renal vein take away this pure blood from the kidney and transfer this blood to the vena cava, and through the vena cava it flows to the or reaches to the heart. So, with the help of the arrows, you have to show the flow of blood. Again, please take a look of this. That is through the aorta, oxygenated blood and the blood which is containing nitrogenous waste which is going to be filtered, coming through the aorta and enter into the kidney through renal arteries. Now, this blood is going to be filtered by the help of kidney excretory units. And excretory waste is collected by the ureter, and the pure blood is going to collect with the help of renal vein and enter into the vena cava and goes to the heart. This is the whole system you have to learn, and always with the help of arrow you have to show the flow of blood. This is all about the excretory system of the human. Now let us, I will tell you how in the form of flow chart how the blood is going to be excreted out. Of the flow chart, I will explain you that through the aorta, impure blood which is going to be filtered with the help of kidney, impure blood which contain nitrogenous waste in it, enter into the kidney through the renal artery. And I want to show you that through the renal artery, when it enters, it separates out. Mainly we are talking about how the blood is going to be separated, the nitrogenous waste, that is blood and nitrogenous waste. No need to write this. Impure blood that is coming from through the aorta and through the renal artery, when it enter into the kidney, this blood and nitrogenous waste going to be separate out, right? Blood is there, nitrogenous waste is there. This blood is very important for us, that will remain in the body, and nitrogenous waste which is not important for us has to be excreted out through the ureter and then to the urinary bladder and then to ejected out through the urethra, right? Now and what about this blood? What happens to this blood, pure blood? This pure blood through the renal vein enter into the largest vein, that is vena cava, and then finally enter back to the heart, because it is very important component of the body. It circulates again into the human body. That's it. Now next I will explain you about the excretory units, structure of them and their function, that is the nephron.